Hi. This morning, I will recall the month of April events in 1966. Firstly and foremost, I was relieved from the job of the instructor in geology in the Department of Geology by 15th of April. And sooner than later, I got a letter from the University of Kerala based on my application for the job of lecturer in geology in the university. I was glad enough to have received it. I took the letter to the professor, Mehron sir, and he read through it and he told me, you study well, prepare well, because it is a competition for a regular appointment. So I said, yes, sir, and I then got involved in what is called the rhomboidal, pyrite, coilal, limestone, etc., etc. And then, of course, one thing I forgot to mention is the interview was to take place during the last week of April. Well, then something else happened. See, from Kollam, the Radha's group, a business group, was publishing what is called Kerala Shabdam, a fortnightly tabloid, and another one, a monthly, on a cinema called Cinema Masika. Well, of course, the point here is about the Kerala Shabdam. In fact, I did not see the Kerala Shabdam at all, and until the interview was over, so to speak. In the Kerala Shabdam, there was supposed to be an article about how the University of Kerala fills up the vacancies of teaching positions in the various departments using their own whims and fancies, and in a very much covert manner, and in which during the process of selection, many of the selected candidates would have had some kind of a connection with some member of the syndicate or the university by one way or other. And it is a little more than half-page article in the front page of the Kerala Shabdam tabloid. And then they quoted saying that, you know, there is soon an interview is going to take place to choose a lecturer in geology in the University of Kerala, and the university will naturally play all the tricks and tricks in order to select their own candidate, and more or less it is a fait accompli. And well, this I learned, I read the paper only later on, after the interview, in fact. Because I know people, it was not a very popular thing, and this particular tabloid, probably Cinema Masiya, was much more welcome in the Kerala, among the Kerala, you know, cinema fans than Kerala Shabdam was. Kerala Shabdam is actually, I'm not saying Kerala Shabdam is a bad anything, but you know, it is a tabloid, it is about the scoop stories. The scooped out stories can be wrong or right, we don't know. And it is never verified by the authority or whatever. So, on the date of interview, you know, we were something like five or six people. And there were, P.K. Thambi was there. And some candidates were from outside Kerala. My classmates, none of them appeared for the interview. on that date, and I applied for the job probably. And around 10:30, I saw a big, fat, tall man in full suit walking to in the veranda toward the place of interview, VC's office. And he was escorted by two or three people who were dressed in munda and ordinary shirt. Of course, well-dressed and well-groomed people. Then these people accompanied this gentleman, and he was probably an expert. But no, he walked into our room where the candidates were seated, then greeted us, introduced himself as Dr. N.L. Reddy. Unfortunately, now he is no more. And he also said that he is a lecturer, he is appearing for the interview, and he is working in the Advanced Center for Studies in Geology in Punjab University. Those days we had two advanced centers in geology. One is in Punjab and the other one is in the Sagar University, Madhya Pradesh. And these two centers had extra financial assistance from University Grants Commission, so they had a better infrastructure for research, etc. And more faculty also, number of teachers are also larger compared to any other postgraduate department. So for the interview, the experts, I still remember the face of Professor Vishwanathayya, because I have seen Professor Vishwanathayya as a student also. So this is the second time, I repeat, in a matter of, say for example, an year and a half or so to speak. Another expert, again in full suit, I did not know. Of course, Professor Menon was there, Professor A. Abraham was there as the Dean of the faculty, representing the university, of course the Vice Chancellor, then some syndicate member and so on. And we were called in, I think alphabetically, by around 12 o'clock, I was called in, I was interviewed for about, 15 or 20 minutes. They were asking questions about basics of geology, what are my research interests, what are my research plans, etc., etc. Because, they told, these experts told me that the university's job is not just research, no, not just teaching. And teaching is also part of the, research is also part of the activity, because research contributes to a lot of new knowledge which can be transferred to or given to the class the teacher will be teaching. So with this, finally they said, okay, thank you. Then I came back out and then took my bicycle and went home straight. I did not go to the department as usual, even though I had I was outside of the so-called instructor's job. Then, the next day when I went in, naturally, as usual, I saw Professor Menon in his office. And he said, he asked me to sit down and told me that I am not selected for appointment. Because this N.L. Reddy, he was the most qualified person for that job, and the university has decided to select him and appoint him soon. So it was kind of a bolt from the blue for me. Then of course quickly I realized that yes, obviously he is among the six or seven who appeared for the interview, he is the most qualified person with a PhD of 5 or 6 years standing and teaching in the Punjab University Chandigarh for 5 or 6 years. He was a student of P.R.J. Naidu, I believe, late P.R.J. Naidu. Naturally, yeah, there is a reputation to the P.R.J. Naidu as well as the students, PhD students. Anyways, but I felt kind of bad and sad indeed, because I have no job. I was hoping that I might, by some chance, there might be, if there is no PhD appearing for the exam, obviously I will stand a very good chance. Well, okay, that is enough. That was enough for that point in time. Then I bade goodbye to sir and told I will go see you tomorrow, sir, like that. And I went out. And in fact, I went straight for, I don't know why it was the driving force that made me to go and see Professor A. Abraham, the dean. And when I went to botany department, Professor Abraham was actually in the botany department garden looking at the plants, so that, you know, looking at their health and how well they are cared about, etc., etc. I, as soon as I walked toward him, you know, tear drops rolled down through my cheeks. And then he called me, he patted me on my back and said, let's go and sit in my office. So once we entered in his office, Sir told me that, you know, freshen up, go freshen up in the bathroom. There is a wash basin there, towel is there, soap is there, if you need that, etc. And then I went in, freshened up, and I wiped my face, and I was tense still. Then Professor Abraham, you know, with a, you know, affectionate way, he told me that, look, young man, you will have a definitely bright career. You are too young, actually. You are only just hardly 22 plus or whatever. And, you know, when an interview like this happens, that university always will go for the best among the candidates who appeared. So, well, the best obviously was the man with the PhD and, you know, teaching experience and research experience. So the university is not going to look for anybody else than him. So he wished me well and, you know, gave me a cup of tea. And then, you know, I said, sir, thank you, sir. And I walked out. I was in a dilemma, obviously. Then anyway, I went into the university library in the next compound. I sat in there with a saddened mind, and not probably with a saddened face. And then I started reading the Newsweek for the current week. You know, right from my BSc days, or late and final year BSc days, I was a visitor to the university library for various reasons. And one of the things I enjoyed right from those days were reading Newsweek. You know, the university library had been subscribing to Newsweek and Time magazine, but somehow I started a personal liking to Newsweek magazine. So I completed a portion of the, you know, it takes 3-4 hours to complete the reading of the one issue. So I read some articles, some features, and then went home. And I told, of course, naturally, mommy was there, amma was there at home as usual. I told her, you know, I am not in the list. Then she consoled me, saying that, don't worry, you will get some other job, you know, in the course of time. And of course, when my brother came in and my parent came, and the father came in, I told, this is the result. I was told so much by the Professor Manuel, etc., etc. And then, anyway, you know, surprisingly, it so happened that the mining and the geology, directorate of geology was looking for assistant geologists. They had taken a list of the candidates from the qualified candidates from the professional employment exchange. And the following week, I get a letter, a memo from the directorate of geology is asking me to join as an assistant geologist in 150-250 scale in Kozhikode, in the regional office. And that was a glad news. That was cheered me up. And then I thought, you know, who else would have gotten it? And well, anyway, we will know it. Where is time is there? They are given 15 days to join. If I do not join within 15 working days, I will lose my chance. So the next day, so happened, I went to East Fort and West Fort actually, where Janardhan and I was living, his home, Janardhan Iyer rather. He is only just a junior to me in the MSc class. And he was there, luckily, and he asked me, hey, you know, did you get the answer, appointment letter? I said, yes, I too got one. What are you? I asked, appointed. He said, he was in Kozhikode. I said, I am too there. So we said, we decided that we will go together to Kozhikode, and in between Janardhan said he has a friend known to him and living in Mangal, a place actually to the east of Kozhikode, Allai Road rather. So we took a bus to there, with enough material to live for a month or several months there, clothing, etc. And then we took a bus, early morning bus to Ernakulam. From Ernakulam, we took another fast passenger to Payyanur fast passenger and purchased a ticket to Kozhikode. And in Kozhikode, we got off at Kozhikode. In fact, from there, we took another bus, yet another bus, to Mangava, where, I know very well, you know what the not the location, but the people. And we went in there, in the house. It is a house shared by some five or six people. And, by about 6 o'clock, a friend of Janardhanan came in, and he greeted us, and how was the trip, etc. Those questions, usual questions, normally queries were made. And then, we ate something for supper and then slept. Next day morning, this guy advised us to take a bus to what is called the main bus stand, city bus stand or whatever, near Imperial Hotel, and get off at Talapuram. And we were told, we got off at Talapuram, and then it was the palm of your hand, we knew what the regional office is. The regional office of geology department those days was housed in a small building, tile roof, tile building, probably an outhouse of a bungalow, and facing the boys Ganapati High School to the east side of it. We walked in, we were rather early for that because only Pune was available. And then Piyun greeted us and asked us, sir, why are you here? We told him this is the reason. He offered some place to sit, and we sat there. We were just asking questions about who are all here. Then he said that our office, the geologist in charge will be there by around 10 o'clock. By 10 o'clock, geologist arrived, and Gopalakrishnan Nair, late of course, now. And he was from Trivandrum. He studied in Jammu University, I think. And then for MSc and BSc, he studied in the University College. And then, the Pune came back and said, sir, you are called in. So both of us went in. Gopalakrishnan Nair greeted us and offered us a seat each. We sat there, after the preliminary questions, he dictated a joining report rather. We wrote it in a piece of white paper, quarter sheet paper, and that was it, we joined. And then by about a quarter after 10, Radhakrishnan Nair, my own classmate, who is a field assistant those days in the department, in that office, as well as Keshwan Nair, who is only a junior to me also, came to the office because they were already on a regular appointment by the PSC. Okay, that is what happened on the new job on the first day in Kozhikode. I will come with